So far, we should have been familiar with the workflow of most network analysis. With the network dataset and the work environment ready, you first create a new network analysis layer, then you add locations, stops, facilities, origins, destinations, then you set analysis settings, and then you solve for solutions. If you're experimenting with different inputs or parameters, you might be repeating these steps over and over again. You can use ArcGIS ModelBuilder to automate this process. Find two boxes in the catalog window, in My Two Boxes, right-click and create the new toolbox. You can call it network analysis or walkability study, whatever you want, and right-click and create the new model. Now, this is a window for ModelBuilder. In this example, I'll create a model performing a surface area analysis. Then use spatial join to calculate the average walkability score within each surface area polygon. So basically what we did in the last video. We're going to use tools with network analyst and analysis. So my first step is to make a new surface area layer. In your case, you might be making a root layer or OD cost matrix. Depending on what you're doing, you might want to use a different tool. And double click it to open the parameters. We choose input analysis network roots ND, that's a network dataset that we created. Time as impedance, I set default break to 5 and 10 minutes. And check length as decumulator. Then remember, we set polygon generation options to disks instead of rings. Right, click OK. Now the tool is colored and there's an input network dataset created. Colored boxes and circles in the model builder mean the data or processes are validated and ready to run. Now let's add the second step, add locations. You see, when I add a new process to model builder, it's not colored, meaning it's not validated. It lacks certain inputs or parameters and cannot run. If you double click, you see this process needs two inputs, a network analysis layer and locations. We do have an empty service area layer created here, so let's create a link between those using the connect tool. Right, choose input network analysis layer. We also need some locations. In this case, we only need one type of locations, facilities for service area analysis. So I'm going to find student building and add that to the model. I create another link between student building and add locations and choose that as input locations. All right, now it's validated. Before we can get our surface area polygons, you have to solve the network analysis. So add solve to the model and connect that with the output surface area. You might notice so far that green circles represent outputs, blue circles are inputs, and yellow boxes are processes. Now we have a model that performs the surface area analysis. You can right-click the final output and check Add to Display. Now if you click Run, it's going to create a surface area layer and add that to the map. So you can see the polygons here. Our model is not done yet because I also want to use spatial join to calculate the average walkability score with each polygon. So let's find the tool spatial join in search box. Add that to the model. If you try to connect the final surface area with spatial join, you might notice that there's not an option to add that as the input. This is because the network analysis layer contains multiple classes, right? For service area, it has facilities, it has points, polygons, lines, and different types of barriers. So we have to select the polygons first before we can add that to spatial join. So go to Insert, Model Only Tools, and select data. Now you can connect the service area layer with select data, use that as input data element. But you see, it automatically selects the facilities, which are not what we want for the spatial join. So double click select data and set the child data element, which is basically the data you're selecting from service area layer, to polygons. right, now you can connect that with spatial join.
We also need the join features, and remember the join features we use the road segments. So adding that to the model.
The model looks a bit messy here. You can use this auto layout to rearrange data and processes so it reflects your workflow. Now double click spatial join to finish the configuration. Remember, we want to calculate the sums of shape month and walkability times length for a weighted average walkability score. So scroll down to these fields, right click, and change the merge rule from first to sum. You can also change the merge rule of walk to mean if you just need the simple mean of walkability scores. Then you can change the output location, and when you're done, click OK. I'm also adding this final output layer to display. Now, if I run the model again, it should create a polygon layer with join attributes, the average and sum of walkability scores.